Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Lunar Eternal Blue Blind. We've just recovered Ronfar from up here, and we're going to go search for the others. We have Jean and Lemina to find, all housed in one of these prisons with the little electrified field thing, I suppose. Well, at least Ronfar was, and we were. And this is where it came from. Oh, there's only one way. Oh, we're gonna get a fight. Oh, good. Need to go back from whence we came. Well, we got our healer back, so that's... I'm very happy about that. Hopefully we can upgrade our magic. I had a bug when I tried to do that last episode. Please let me, I'll just attack this round. I can't get over the stupid mask. The way the smile or whatever the hell it is, or the sneer with the mask, it's the height of ridiculousness. And Ronfar doesn't even get a chance to go. And yes, I know Mr. E, otherwise known as Leo, is running low on magic. We'll hit that, we'll find that statue again. Right in the doorway. It's like one extra step or something. One extra pixel we hit. Him attack this time. I don't know if we've seen him attack physically. Not bad. See if Ronfar could possibly finish him off. Oh, okay. So that's how we'll handle those guys from now on, because I think Post Sword only loses 3 mana. Ugh. Close sword. Attack that guy, attack that guy. They have it set up so we get one fight per level. Let's start fast forwarding these because it's really rinse repeat. Okay. Right. Okay. This is the ground floor and we can't get through that door. Okay, so now we need to just continue. One of these guys again. Italian sword. Attack them all. Thank you. That didn't finish them off by themselves, so. Way to go, hero. Hope we level up soon. Okay, we definitely use a little topping off here. At the least. So glad we have Ronfar with us. Actually glad we found him first. He's our healer. I didn't even mean to do that, by the way. And I had no idea where these frickin' tunnels go. I know they go underground to the other three towers from that first tower that we were in, but I know the other two directions we have to go. So, as I suspect, we just have to keep going west down this corridor, but I want to head north first to hit the statue, I think, to replenish our mana, stuff like that, so. Calm litanies, everyone. Let's just do it again. We both need about 40 points each. Okay, I think we want to continue west, but statues up here. Good. Replenished. Oh, we're going to hit it again because we're right next to it. Do the Rock Viper. We're gonna replenish anyway, so. I didn't do that much damage. And I like the visual of it, believe me. It's really ineffectual lightning blast. And you don't think there could be anything, any such thing as a ineffectual lightning blast, but apparently. As least steps as possible. Save here. So I'm wondering if this game is actually going to be longer than the first. We're getting there. Okay, oh yeah, yeah. Topping off here. Definitely close enough with Hero. Okay, so now we should be headed to that other tower. Right, there's the guys outside, and we can't go in there. Dead endo. Okay, if you go. My good friend Ruben, Snarfle, Ghost Toast, etc. told me a neat trick that when you enter the level, you have a certain amount of steps or distance you can cover before you get into a fight. I thought it was completely random, like had some random element. I mean, it might, you know, but not by a large amount. So, say, for example, we can get to the edge of the screen on the right here before getting into a fight. We'll probably go a little further than that, but. And then we get in that fight, it resumes. But say we walk down south and then go back up, we're gonna get in a fight before we reach that level. So you can always go like that. Just to reset. If you're getting sick of the. See. You can Because I do want to see what's in these rooms without getting in endless fights. But I believe we've seen all we can see. Try physical attacks on the flyboys this time, see how we do. We hit Ron far hard. Oh, now we don't have to run up to you. Well, most of us don't. Yeah, we had to go to a second round. You can't defeat them all with physical in one round. I mean, maybe almost, but one hit should do it. Yep. Yeah, we're gonna end up topping off after every fight like that. A chest! 2,395. So now, because we opened the chest, when you open a chest, your steps or whatever, your distance doesn't reset. So that's how they get us. Hold on a second. Okay. I hate when I wear my headphones and my ear itches. Especially whilst recording. Topping off again. Oh, there's a chest here. A soul staff? Could Ron Far use that? Can't equip. It's probably for Lemina. Oh, let's have Ron for hold on to it then. Speaking of Lemina. Whew! Talk about mega nick of time. I didn't know if you guys were even still alive. Hey, who's the party dude in the mask? Ruby says, funny you should ask. Rhymes. We're playing a little game. Lord Leo has decided to play this part called Mr. E, and we're playing along. We're not supposed to know who he is, but he's helping us. I think. Whatever floats his boat. Anyway, I can't believe what that stupid Borgen did. I'll never forgive him. I hope he chokes on all the food he eats. Get a load of this. Well, well, Borgen says, if it isn't my dear Lemina. You're the last person I would have expected to see in Pentagulia. Shut up, you overweight toad. Yeah, this is replaying our conversation that we overheard at the door, just south of here. And, like the conversation with Ron Far, it's bound to go further. I'm tired of listening to your trite speeches. I have two reasons for being here. The first is to rescue my mother. And the second is to make sure that you never again set foot in vain. I find your manner so, I don't know, delicious. You're always hell-bent on changing others. Perhaps you should consider changing yourself. Besides, your mother is no longer in Pentagulia. She's busy making a new home for us in Neovane, my illustrious magic city. Neovane? Yes, that's right, Neovane, cupcake. And surprises of surprises, she loves it. Doubt that. But why shouldn't she? Her surroundings are that of a queen. I have given her the finest of everything in this world. And all I ask is that she grow to love me. Despite what you think, it can be done. If you try hard enough, I'm certain you can do the same. What? I'll think of you as the daughter I never had. Okay, he's talking about daughter. Daughter? Yes, soon Miria will agree to be my wife. I can feel it. After Miria and I are united, your ability to revive the Magic Guild of Vayne will be forever sealed. I'm afraid you don't stand a chance of stopping me, Cream Puff. I won't allow you to do this. I suggest you get a handle on your emotions, sweetie. Soon the only words you'll utter will be those of a loyal daughter. When Zophar is revived, the power of Neo Vayne will finally be... Oops. I almost let the cat out of the bag. I can't let you in on that little secret until we're back in Neo Vayne. Believe me, Poopsie. You feel right at home. What's all these names? But since you feel a little... Since you seem a little adverse to the idea right now, I'd better put you in a holding cell. Sweet dreams. Daughter. Well, that's a freaking nightmare. There's no way that I'm going back to Neo Vayne with that bucket of lard. We've got to find a way out of here so I can rescue my mother. Alright. How's she doing? She is full. And, as far as items, she has room for one, like the staff. Oh, man. Wisdom goes up. Wow. The attack power is... Ugh. That's unfortunate. Did they think in this at this point in the game that we wouldn't have the other... the Mystic Bow yet? And I had plenty of money to get that Mystic Bow. I have plenty of money left over. Look, she's got a silver light, too. It's awesome. Gives you back, I think, all your magic. Yep. Alright, so... Ruby! Hold on to that, please. Thank you. Alright, now we just gotta completely leave here. So how are we doing, anyway? We're fine. Just fine. Oh. You know, if you hit one of the side directionals... We're gonna get in a fight, because I walk back and forth. Probably would've gotten anyone anyway, right at that doorway. Yeah, if you hit those side directionals... I'm gonna attack physically now. You go back in. It's annoying. Man, it's bouncing off. Hero levels up. Hooray. So he's level 28. He's tied with Ronfar and above Lemina and Leo. So glad Hero finally caught up. Well, now Mystery is equal. So it's just Lemina who's behind. So we all could use a little topping off. You think so? You know, I'm only going to do it because Leo is so low. So that's why. Otherwise I'd leave it, you know, because the rest of us are, you know, within 20 or 30 points. That's better. Huh. Leo's been getting a little banged up lately. Okay, backtracking. Back to the last tower, I get Gene. Saying about Leo? I just want to keep him near top just in case. We can get back our mana up here. So we're done with this section down here. Actually, we might as well just go by the statue and walk until we get in the fight. So it's save 500 silver. We all got banged up in that fight, especially Hero. But we can just do that and all is good. And I think we go up this way. Back behind us, in the opposite direction, is the tower we came from. I believe. I'm pretty sure. We're back to magic attacks, because these ninjas are really real pain. Literally. Plus they're all going to attack before we get a chance to do anything. Lemina, wow. Okay. We've got these Necro Knight dudes left. He kicked it away, you see that? He just kicked it. Either that or it tickled him and made him make a funny stance. What do you say? Physical attacks? Yeah, personal attacks. Those are personal attacks on that one. Let's do finish off that one. Topping off. Top Hero extra bit. I mean, even though he's caught up to everyone, he still gets his butt kicked. Maybe we just need to find some better armor for him or something. Not that we've seen a shot for quite a long time. Yep, these guys. So this is where Gene is being kept in Master Lun. Why did he imprison her again? I thought he was one of the good guys. $11.15 silver. Fight. Knew it. Only two of these ninja guys. What do you say? Save our mana and... You know, let's save our mana. Let's attack physically the top one. And have Lemina I'm gonna do flame on this one. I want to see if she can finish off just one with that flame. And if we can finish off one with physical, I'm sure, yeah, the two of us, Leo and Hero, can do it. He actually gets to go first before the ninja, that's rare. Oh, here we go. And they only attacked once, that thing? Flame shot. Oh, he is damaged, though. But he is dead. Oh, you think it's necessary to top anyone off? Leo again? Like mad scientist music. Oops. Let's reset. I didn't mean to do that. I'm gonna go that way. Holy water. Now, I think Hero's full, given that. We'd all be full. Does anyone have any holy water? That's spring water. There's holy water. Bonfire has one. Hmm. Yeah, let's hold on to it. I mean, if we need to pick anything up, it's just going to automatically go to Bonfire. So, whatever. Fight any second. Yep. Hmm. Heal Hero. We couldn't even see them because they were behind the wall. Dover net. Okay, we'll hold on to that. Lanfor can keep that. Reset. I mean, maybe we should get in the fights just to strengthen us, but I'm kind of bored of them now. Gene! Thank goodness. I've been counting the minutes since they locked me in that cell. I was hoping you were all okay. Say, what's Leo doing with you? Is he working for the goddess? Ruby says, well, yes and no. Near as we can tell, this is some sort of party game Leo's playing. He's dressed up and calls himself Mr. E. He's the one that rescued Hero and me from the cell first. Alright then, Mr. E it is. Listen, some really bad stuff is going on here. When I went to see Master Lun to report on the Blue Dragon cult, I discovered something very interesting. Do tell us. Lun says, ah, it's been some time since our last encounter, Gene. What brings you all the way to Pentagulia? It's this mask. I took it from the leader of the Blue Dragon cult. But what good is this mask? Didn't you get a look at the leader? No, he covered his face before I could get a look at it. He was in such a hurry to get away, though, that he dropped the mask. His voice seemed so very familiar, but I can't put my finger on it. Be Lun himself? Ha ha ha. Gene, you were always my best student, but you never knew when to give up, to leave well enough alone. Your best student? What are you talking about? It was you! You were the leader of the cult. Dun, dun, dun. I'm surprised it took you so long to put it together. But then again, you were bred to fight, not to think. And fight you did. Under my watchful eye, your fighting skill increased 100-fold. Yes, but you forced me to use that skill for death and destruction. I was nothing more than an assassin for your corrupt cause. You stole my childhood, Len. I'll never forgive you for that. Never is such a strong word. Think about it, Jean. I molded you into what you are today. You should thank me. You molded me into what? An emotional wreck who is always running from a past I don't understand? Or maybe a trained killer who can never live a normal life? You took everything I had and gave me nothing in return. You never cared about me. I was simply another child whose soul you would blacken for your evil purpose. A trusting child whose innocence you would tear away with no remorse. He's getting into it here. Jean, you make it sound so harsh. I did care about you. Your skill was beyond anything I had encountered. You were special. We could have gone far together. But your rebellion has made us adversaries. I will always be the adversary of evil. You must be stopped. Well then, Jean, the time has come for your final lesson. And a hard lesson it will be. I don't believe. Your karate has grown so strong. Lun, you can't. Obviously he can, and he did. And the next thing I knew, I was in this cell. We have to find a way to stop Lun. He can't be allowed to continue stealing the innocence of children. His newer, stronger black karate of death cannot be allowed to spread. Leo says, okay, now that the tearful reunion is finished, I've finished my task. Your next step is entirely up to you. Good luck. Ruby says, I don't know what we would have done if Leo, Mr. E, hadn't come. I'm certain he saved our lives. I just think it's funny that he thinks he's fooling us with that mask. Ranfoss says, if members of Althena's cult knew that he was helping us, they would not only kill him, but Mari as well. I think he realized that this was the only way he could help us. Yes, but he's not fooling anyone with that. He has a good heart. I just hope he leaves the cult before it's too late. Okay. State of the Union. Jean's back. This is the stuff she has. What is this again? Oh, Angel Tears. So he took the mask back, I guess, yeah. Okay. Thanks for watching. See you next time when we try to get the hell out of here. See you then, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.